Hello everyone, it's Lisa here and welcome back to my channel. So today we are building a micro cottage, and I really like how this one turned out because it's so cute and tiny and cozy, and there are a lot of plants everywhere. So I tried to make it look as overgrown as possible without making it look too overgrown. And yeah, so there's also a pond in the front later on, which I will add later. Yeah, obviously not now, because now I'm still figuring out the shape of the house. And yeah, this has 32 tiles, the whole small cottage here, and I think that's amazing. So there is also space for two Sims in total here, and I quite enjoy that. So there is just this small tiny cottage, and I managed to put in two Sims here. I think that's amazing. Yeah, so also I'm sorry if this voiceover is going to be kind of messy, because I'm kind of in a hurry a little bit, because I am going with a friend outside today, and we are going hiking, and I'm super excited for that because I haven't been hiking in months, and that's something I quite enjoy doing. So yeah, just wanted to mention that before, that maybe some parts are going to be a little bit messy because I tend to mess up voiceovers sometimes, but it's okay. Yeah, and yeah, here I'm doing some tricks so that I won't go over the tile count. So I'm, yeah, adding the walls separately to this little chimney here that I added. And now I'm trying to figure out which windows I want to use, and this took some time. I think I cut out most of it because I was so indecisive about those windows, but I end up with these ones from Get Together. Yes. And here I'm adding the chimney so that it looks more natural and that there's actually something coming out of it. Even though now that I'm thinking about it, there is no fireplace on the inside, but yeah, I think it could be like maybe coming from a stove or something like that. I think that's also quite realistic. I don't know. Yeah, anyways. And here you can see one thing I did is not here with the door. That's also what I did, but that's not what I meant. I'm adding these base game bushes to the columns, and I really like how this looks. And I got the idea from one of Miss Semrino's videos, I think in one of her latest base game videos. Yeah, she does a lot of base game videos at the moment, and so if you're into base game, check it out. And yeah, if you only have base game, you can check her out, because she's doing some amazing videos in the past few weeks with which are just base game, so that's pretty nice. And yeah, so she placed this bush around a column, and I think that looks quite nice. And yeah, actually one of my subscribers mentioned that to me so that I should check it out, and I did, and I was amazed by it. So yeah. So no counts, not counts, how do you say that, the copyright goes to Miss Simrino and not to me. It's not a copyright, but you know what I mean. Credits, the credits go to Miss Simrino. Now I got it. Okay. So, you could already have seen me placing some more greenery overall, and here I'm adding these flowers, which are from, or not flowers, it's more like ivy, and they are from the Jungle Adventure Pack, and I absolutely adore these flowers. I think it's so amazing that they are like on the wall, and we need more plants like that. I really like how they look, and yeah, so I'm adding them, I think, around the whole cottage. And I'm also lining it up a little bit with some ivy from Get Together, yeah, here, so that it doesn't look that plain, so that there's still some dimension to it. And I really like how that looked. So I'm adding them everywhere. And here also you can see on the side those hanging plants, and I will delete them later on, sadly, because they are like sticking on the inside of the house. They are like, yeah, poking through the wall, and it doesn't look good. So I had to delete them because I couldn't make it work. But yeah, I will add a lot of hanging plants, or not a lot, some. I will add some hanging plants on the outside as well. So that there is still some more greenery overall. And now I'm adding some lamps, and I think the shape of the house is already finished, and I'm just adding some fairy lights everywhere because I love fairy lights. I think they're looking so cute. And yeah, I totally would want to spend like some days here in this tiny cottage, like for vacation maybe. And yeah, it's so green everywhere, and like in the middle of this island here, or it's not an island, but like, you know, surrounded by the lake, and I think that's so beautiful. Yeah, so it is built in Windenburg, if I haven't mentioned that before. I think I didn't. And it's on the Haus am See lot, and this, I really don't know why it has a German name. It's called Haus am See, and that's the German term. And yeah, in German, like translated to English, it just means like cottage am See. Wait, is it called cottage am See? I don't know. But what I mean, it's like a cottage by the lake. So yeah, I think it's maybe German because the whole word is inspired by Germany. Or at least some European countries, or at least that's what I heard. I could be wrong about that. But for the family who lives here, I was thinking that they are also like really into nature, and they like to be on the outside, in the woods maybe, or yeah. And that they also like gardening. So I gave them some gardening space, and yeah, I also placed down some plants already from the gallery so that you don't have to like grow them by yourself. And yeah, so here I'm adding this little pond that I was talking about earlier. And I really like how this one turned out. And yeah, I was a little bit too afraid that I maybe like overdid it with the whole flowers and the whole bushes everywhere. But I think it's okay because it's supposed to look overgrown. And yeah, for the whole landscaping color scheme, I went with this white plants everywhere and also some touches of yellow. And I think that's also on the inside. There's like those beige colors everywhere and those light brown ones and white and also yellow. So that's the whole color scheme for this house, yeah. And here on the outside you can see this drying rack, is that how you say it? Yeah, like where you dry your clothes. And this one is actually from Island Living, from the debug menu. But you can of course just switch it out for one which is from Laundry Day, or you can just delete it as well. I just like the look of it, and that's why I placed it there. It's, yeah, it gives some details to everything, so yeah. And here I'm adding like this flower arrangement table, and I like how messy it looks a little bit because I didn't place it like right next to the wall. And I don't know, I like that it looks a little bit different. Yeah, so here I'm also adding an outdoor area where your Sims can eat, but there's also actually one on the interior. Oh, and here I'm adding this little flower box, which is from the Country Kitchen kit that we got recently. And I tried to make it look like it holds the door open, and I like how that looked. Yeah, I'm also using the Country Kitchen kit on the inside for the kitchen. Yeah, obviously. And I think also some decorative pieces, but yeah, but it's totally not necessary for this build because you can just swap out the counters and the cabinets and then you should be fine. Yeah. So now we are going on to landscaping and adding some more trees. And here in the front you could have seen me doing those lines with the terrain paint. And there I will add some flowers and vegetables. Yeah, here now I'm doing it. I just took this room from the gallery and yeah, placed down a lot of plants and tried to make it look nicer. I really enjoy doing this lately because it gives so much more depth to your builds, I think, or not that much, but a little bit. And like that the plant boxes are not empty, so that they are full, if you know what I mean. I'm not that good at explaining. But yeah, and now I'm just seeing that I forgot one bush there, and that one bush here is still like flying in the air a little bit because I lowered them all with the tool mod, but I forgot to select one. So okay, but I think your Sims can still use it, but Yeah, okay. I think the exterior is finished now, and I've just added a mailbox and also a trash can on the outside because I forgot about that. And yeah, or I wanted to do it earlier, but then I didn't. But anyway, here we are on the interior, and I'm doing the bathroom first. And I also, first I wanted to keep in the whole floor planning process, but then I realized it's just one wall. And also, I don't know why, but I was like spinning the camera like crazy doing this floor plan, and even I got dizzy while watching it, and I didn't even speed it up that much. And yeah, I don't know. So I had to cut that out because otherwise you all will be getting really dizzy. But here you can, yeah, I think the bathroom is finished, and now you can see me using the new counters here, and I will switch the color to a more, yeah, I think to the, how do you say that? It's the beige color, yes. And also I'm adding these cabinets from Jungle Adventure because I didn't want to use the cabinets from the Country Kitchen kit because they have, like the smaller ones, they have only like plates there, and I didn't like how that looked because it would be, I don't know. I think that's one issue about the new kit. I really do adore this kit, but it's not like, if you place a lot of items from it like next to each other, there are so many clutter items in the cabinets, and it will look a little bit weird because it's quite repetitive. And do you know what I mean? I hope so. Yeah, okay. But the kitchen is finished, and I'm adding a little dresser. And this one is from Tiny Living, and it doesn't really fit the whole aesthetic here on the interior, I would say, but it's small and it fitted there, and I wanted to give the Sims living here a dresser, so I took this one, but I think it's okay, it's not that bad. Yeah, and adding some more plants, and what else is coming? Oh, I think, yeah, this is one thing I realized I was really amazed by, that I, yeah, you can see that this is a cabinet from the Kitchen Country pack, and I could use it like as a I can't talk anymore. I've used it as a side table here, and yeah, I think that was quite clever. But okay, we are at the end of the video, so if you liked it, then you can give it a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel if you haven't done that already, and also you can push that bell so that you can get notified if I upload a video. That would be also quite nice if you do that, or I don't know, whatever. So yeah, I hope you liked this video, and I will hopefully see you all in my next one. Bye!